You know, I really don't get it. Why don't you guys just always believe me? What have I said several times? At the end of the day, Frankie Boy was right. For those of you that don't know, John Venus admitted to eating eggs, but 5 months ago, I made a video exposing him that he was eating eggs. John completely ignored my video, never made a response to it, and even shortly after that, Vegan Gains was happy to jump to his defense. I received a direct message on Instagram from a vegan, nevertheless, who noticed that John Venus, who's a vegan bodybuilder, had posted an Instagram story with what appears to be a carton of eggs in his refrigerator. This vegan, as you can imagine, was pretty upset, claiming that he doesn't like liars, not too happy about the situation. If he reached out to me, you know, a carnivore meat-based dieter who criticizes vegans on a regular basis. Now, this may or may not be a carton of eggs, but I am convinced that John Venus, as well as other vegan bodybuilders, are lying and misleading their viewers.
All right, so Frank Tufano is suggesting that the supposed vegan bodybuilder John Venus isn't actually vegan, and Frank is assuming this because he's come across this video clip where John was opening up his refrigerator and you can see a couple cartons of eggs in his refrigerator. Well, Frank, there are two possibilities here. On the one hand, it's possible that John is a fake vegan and he's been eating eggs behind everyone's back. Or the much more likely scenario is that John happens to live with someone who isn't vegan and they share a refrigerator. And it just so happens the latter is true. John Venus lives with his wife's parents, and his wife's parents aren't vegan, and they share a refrigerator.
You sound pretty sure of that, buddy.
This happened a year ago, and what happened was that I started eating eggs again, or it was an experiment.
Hey, I guess not. One hell of an experiment, right? But he still claims he's a 5-year vegan and will never go back to a regular diet. Sounds like, oh, it's just a prank, bro. Yeah, we were just pranking each other in the sauna in the gym.
I'm still 100% vegan. I've been vegan for 5 years now, and I have zero plans of ever going back.
His justification was that many of his viewers were reaching out to him once he had a child, saying that it was irresponsible for his child to be on a vegan diet.
Do I believe still that the plant-based diet is the most healthy and the best suitable diet for everyone? I do, if it's well planned, if it's done properly. So when our son was born, we got a lot of hate from people who were very against the plant-based diet. We got threats, we got people calling child services. On top of that, I had nice people reach out as well, and people who were on a plant-based diet who failed on it and felt unhealthy and claimed how eating eggs and fish, but especially eggs, made them feel so much better within a day. I wanted to experiment on myself because that felt like the most responsible thing to do. I had to let go of the idea that I was gonna be a bad person for doing this, or I was doing something unethical, because, you know, it's, how could it be unethical to try to make sure that you're doing the best by your child? This is not something that I regret. This is not something that I feel ashamed of. This is not something that I'm necessarily proud of either, but it is something that my brain decided to do, and this is how I think, and I don't judge anyone else for doing things differently.
Sounds like a bunch of mental hamstering. Similar to what vegans do to create this false Bambi reality, doesn't matter the circumstance, vegans are always right. The no true Scotsman fallacy. And they can't do anything wrong, as long as they still identify as vegan. All of these vegans seem to forget they eat about 15 ants worth of nut butter every day. Oh, and don't forget the sprinkling of rabbit blood on their oatmeal.
So I talked to Catherine, my wife. She was not a big fan of the idea at all, which is 100% understandable. I wasn't even a fan of my own idea. So what ended up happening is that I visited a very, very small local farm that has backyard eggs and they never slaughtered their chickens. I'm not saying that is a ethical thing to do, to eat backyard eggs, but it was the less cruel thing to do in my eyes. And that is what I chose. So I bought a carton of eggs So I believe it was 12. In the span of 3 days, I ate a dozen eggs to see if I would notice anything different, because I thought, if I've been vegan for 4 years and I ate these eggs, 12 of them, after 4 years, I should have been deficient in something as a vegan if this diet isn't optimal. And I should feel some sort of benefit after eating eggs, as eggs has all of the nutrients that, you know, all animal products have combined into one thing. So that's part of the reasoning. I would never be able to eat meat anyway. The first egg I had, I remember it smelled horrible. I had a bite. It wasn't disgusting or anything like that. But I remember by the third or fourth egg, I was like gagging and didn't find it a pleasant experience at all.
So let me get this straight. You cooked up 4 eggs, but the experiment was so disgusting, vile, dead, rotten animal flesh that after you ate that first egg, you choked down the rest of them. Yeah. Okay, buddy. The cognitive dissonance here is unbelievable.
So, did I notice anything? Did I actually see a benefit? Did my back injury suddenly heal? Did my libido suddenly increase? Did I get better mental clarity? Did I, cure anything? And the answer is absolutely not. Nothing. Absolutely nothing happened apart from me getting constipated. That was like the first time.
What a liar, dude. What a weaselly little liar. If he's willing to lie for a year about eating eggs, do you sincerely think anything else he says should be taken truthfully? He's probably been sucking down hen periods every single week. This is the craziest thing about vegans. They commit themselves to a nutrient-deficient lifestyle, and if they cheat on their diet, they're misleading their viewers. A carnivore diet, keto diet, any normal diet is not misleading if you cheat on it, because there are no additional beneficial nutrients found in plant foods. Plus, you know, when carnivores do admit to deviating from their diet, whether it's alcohol or chocolate or coffee, no one seems to care. But God forbid you look at an animal when you're on a vegan diet, they want to pin you to a cross. The reason John was constipated, I mean, maybe it was because he was having sleepovers with his brother, but that's a whole different story. I'm speculating that his digestion slowed down because of the highly bioavailable animal nutrition that was introduced to his stomach in the form of a chicken egg. His body was literally trying to squeeze out every single vitamin, mineral, element, fatty acid that it could have.
And I did consider doing it for a longer period of time because, you know, for these experiments to be as accurate as possible, even though anecdotal experiments are horse shit, I just didn't feel like I wanted to, you know, exploit these chickens and do this anymore.
Stop calling it an experiment. You're not a vegan and you never were. You know what an experiment is? Having a child on a vegan diet, malnourishing the sperm and the egg, the fetus during pregnancy, the breast milk of the mother, that's a true experiment and an evil one at that. Not to mention the millions of people John has probably influenced to do the same thing, yet he thinks telling people he sucked down some eggs is an experiment, and that's something that's okay to do to that type of audience.
So many people, because of all this fear mongering out there and the pushback against the plant-based diet, a lot of people so concerned about choline, B12, omega-3s, iron, these things that we know we can get on a plant-based diet, but there are a lot of people who are concerned about it. So I always tell people, there are a million ways of doing a plant-based diet. There are a million different ways of doing it. What, just because your way doesn't work doesn't mean that another way is not going to work.
Yes, there are a million ways to do a diet, but every single group of humans that have ever existed on this planet have consumed at least 45% of their calories from animal foods. You know, one group might have ate bison and shellfish, another fish and tubers, perhaps shellfish. You know, we know the vegan tribe lives off of tubular human flesh. The point is, the burden of proof is on vegans, and at this point, they should just admit that millions of people have suffered due to misinformation about the diet. Go live in a laboratory with an IV feed of synthetic fat-soluble vitamins and fatty acids that you didn't apparently need from animal foods. You'll start feeling real good then, because it's not from an animal.
I believe in veganism the most out of everyone I know. I think I believe in veganism the most. I really do.
Johnny boy, your brain is still fried from that vegan diet. Maybe you should fry up some more eggs. I'm up at 4 a.m. filming this dumb video, and I'm still fairly competent. Yeah, maybe a little salty and abrasive, but that's probably just because I'm from New York.
I 100% believe that a plant-based diet is suitable for everyone, for all stages of life. My kid, I'm super confident about. He's super healthy.
Go ahead, roll that dice. When your son has crooked teeth, can't see, and he's staring at boys instead of girls, say it's just genetic. You really want to gamble the health of your kid on this vegan nonsense?
I'm just here trying to be myself and trying to, you know, progress as a human being in this crazy world that we're living through, and just trying to do my part to make this world a little bit better. So I applaud you guys for trying to do the same. We're a tribe, we're a family.
No, you're some clown who got sucked into the vegan dogma and are continuing to damage the health of millions of people. What exactly are you doing, John? Selling vegan protein powder? Collecting checks from special interest groups? Maybe it's time to reach out to Cargill. They seem to be handing out sponsorships to anyone who mutters the word butcher box. Thank you guys for joining me. If you could please like the video, subscribe, hit that bell icon. Above all, guys, please share the video. Just visit my channel every day. If you guys do want to support me further, you can visit Frankie's Free Range Meat, which is apparently now an excuse for every single vegan to attempt to discredit my video, saying, oh, now he sells meat. I made YouTube videos for years and years and years, and now I plan on upgrading my 2001 Ford Taurus, hopefully sometime within a year or two. You guys can also check out Frankie's Naturals, minimal ingredients, minimally processed hygiene and cosmetic products. If you guys do want to reach out to me for one-on-one health consultations to look like you were chiseled out of marble, send me an email, frank@frank-tofano.com. Thanks again for joining me, guys. Enjoy the rest of your day.